This presentation features a field on the Northwest Australian Shelf. As we focus on the field, we can see some 3D seismic and well data. Taking a closer look, we have in fact an exploration well and two appraisal wells. The structure seen in the map is a regional unconformity, which forms the reservoir seal. The reservoir is highly faulted, but by selecting the correct orientation, we can observe the stratigraphic nature of the prospect. The total size of the field is approximately 5 kilometres, with the distance between wells around 2 kilometres apart. Our objective as geoscientists is not only to locate, but also to reduce the risk and uncertainty of the prospect. The best way to do this is to fully understand the stratigraphy of the data by integrating as much data in the most dynamic way possible. Let's take a look at the seismic and wells in more detail. Starting with a seismic section through the prospect, we can see the anomaly that first caught our attention, a dipping bright reflector. The reflector appears at the base of a conformable package of reflectors. The upper bounding surface of the sequence can also be seen in the map view and has a strong angular unconformity that looks like it might be forming a stratigraphic trap. We can clearly see some faulting, which could also form a seal or additional subcompartments. The wells on this section show clear correlation between the high-density wireline information and the low-frequency seismic traces. To get a clearer view of the well detail and understanding of the stratigraphy, the wells can be opened in the single well view. Here, we can plot multiple logs and use colour fills to highlight features of interest. Clearly see the shales, sand bodies and coarsening up sequences. Differences between the deep and shallow resistivity or the neutron density crossover clearly show the hydrocarbon potential in these units. To interpret multiple wells, they can be placed side by side in the correlation view. This view has a typical log for correlation, gamma ray, resistivity, density. Also shown is the caliper log, which is a good indicator of borehole conditions, and in well 1, spontaneous potential log, which is a good indicator of bed boundaries. Initially, the seismic and correlation views are linked using the cursor location. We can see our target event, which is this clearly defined sand unit. The seismic section shows a very continuous strong event, and we can now display our existing interpretation. Notice that as I display in the section view, a marker is automatically populated in the well to show the intersection of the well and the horizon. The integration of views provides an incredibly useful guide, giving me my initial rough seismic pick directly in the correlation view. In the correlation view, using the horizon intersection as a guide, I can confirm my top target pick. It is in fact called the top mark. I can repeat this for the next strong event above the target, and the strong central event that appears to be a maximum flooding surface. There is one more event, a high sand system tract that passes through all three wells, and finally I can pick the angular unconformity that tops the sequence. Each time I make a horizon interpretation, I automatically see the horizon intersection with the well. This allows me to make fine pick adjustments in the wireline data to give an accurate interpretation quickly and easily. Using flattening, it's easy to stratigraphically datum the data to view it as a depositional time sequence rather than current day structure. The thickness changes between top mac and top intra bar are minimal, confirming the depositional conformance clearly observed in the seismic. The thickness changes between bar and the intra bar high stand systems tract above it show an up dip thinning. Checking the seismic section, this is most likely explained by the increased faulting that occurs near SB2. The upper section from bar to top bar clearly shows up-dip thinning caused by the angular unconformity. This is a classic feature of an unconformity in a flattened sequence display. Our wireline information is telling us a lot of things about our stratigraphy. A clear coarsening up sequence from a deep water clastic sequence to a near-shore fluvial environment. We've interpreted the geology and geophysics using multiple data views to get maximum integration. We can also display all the data together in a single view, This is true integration and the way we prefer to do all our correlations. As well as stratigraphically flattening the well data, one or more dynamic datums can be applied to the seismic section effectively using a sequence stratigraphic framework or an equivalent of a pseudo-Wheeler diagram. This is done on the fly through the use of dynamic processes. This first process flattens the seabed. Instead of looking at modern-day structure, we're now looking at a pseudo-time sequence event. Here is seabed and unconformity below. This can be repeated for multiple events, typically for the unconformities that represent breaks in continuous time. When we introduce all of the unconformities, we see the sequences shown. Although we don't get a true Wheeler diagram, geological time is the y-axis, we do have the tools to observe and understand this sequence much more clearly. Because this can all be done through a dynamic process calculation, it doesn't involve lengthy computations creating multiple extra volumes of data, we can experiment iteratively to get the best results possible. The calculation is applied in 3D, and so as well as seeing data in sections, we can easily go and see the stratigraphic flattened data in slice view. Looking at a slice of the bar maximum flooding surface, I can slice down through the dataset looking for any internal structure or anomalies. Flattening the data is a great way to pull out extra information, but even this view can be improved. You can see that not all the horizons are quite flat, such as the top max seen here. We can go back to the time section and use the multi-horizon interpretation mode to propagate the whole sequence. The result is a series of horizon rafts clearly seen here in the section view. The picked horizons can be displayed with or without the seismic backdrop to highlight any terminations, such as the down-dipping ones against the bright intra-bar event. By observing these terminations, we can define this as a prograding sequence. They can also be displayed in the map view with an amplitude extraction applied. New subtle information can be extracted, and the full stratigraphy of the project can be determined. Something of immediate interest is a series of bright spots seen along the intra-bar. Are these channel features or tuning effect from the terminating events above? It is very easy to animate up and down through the events, starting with the top Mach event, which is consistently bright with little internal structure. Moving up through the sequence, we reach the intra-bar event, showing the series of bright spots. They don't look particularly channel-like, more like giant ripples. They're possibly forsets from prograding strata that are tuning amplitudes as they pinch out. A quick cross-plot of isochron thickness versus amplitude shows a clear anomaly that can be highlighted and linked back to the map view. This shows a direct correlation between the anomaly and the bright spots confirming the tuning effect and the prograding strata. It is by looking at the individual events that we can see the subtlety of the seismic character. To really understand the 3D complexity of the dataset, you should be using your integrated system to view the data in as many different ways as possible. Using the 3D view, we can easily view the internal structure of the units we've just interpreted. By stripping away the data we are not interested in, I can get down to just the high amplitude events, showing the bright ripple-like features again, confirming that they are a tuning feature rather than a feature of interest. Sometimes we get lucky, sometimes we don't. That's what the system is all about, quantifying the risk so we don't drill false targets. In conclusion, through a highly integrated approach with dynamic updates, a full stratigraphic understanding can be achieved. We have resolved our sequence of events with erosional unconformity, showing channels, foresets, and turbidite delivery channels. This gives us a significant understanding of the targets and reduces the risks that build up when only one view of the data is used. If you have questions or would like to discover more, then visit our website at www.dog.com. And remember, have fun with insight.